The Friday Footy Show, proudly brought to you by Towards Zero for the 2018-19 TIO NTFL season. In round six, we head over to the beautiful Tiwi Islands, while back in Darwin, there's the women's grand final rematch and a massive triple header at TIO Stadium. This weekend at TIO Stadium, AFLNT will commemorate Remembrance Day by giving Defence Force personnel free entry if they show their ID at the gate. And on Sunday, the teams playing are encouraged to wear red armbands. Two games scheduled to start at 11 a.m. will start a little bit later after marking a minute's silence to acknowledge 100 years since the Western Front fell silent during World War I. On Saturday, the action starts early with top-of-the-table clash and the return of last season's grand finalists. The Darwin Buffettes will play Waratah at 10:30 a.m. on TIO Stadium. And then from 2:30 p.m, Wanderers and the Palmerston Magpies will kick off the big triple header. That game will be followed by the Darwin Buffaloes taking on Waratah before the 7:30 p.m. clash between ladder leaders Southern Districts and Nightcliff. The AFL Premiership Cup will make its first ever visit to the Tiwi Islands this weekend as West Coast Eagles coach Adam Simpson joins his Premiership player Willie Rioli in showing off the prestigious cup on his island home. Rioli kicked the first goal for the Eagles in their 5-point grand final win over Collingwood back in September, and we know how much the Tiwi people love their footy, so we're sure he'll be met by hundreds of enthusiastic fans. All this is set to take place around the big Tiwi Bombers and St Mary's game. Will a bit of premiership magic spur the Bombers on to their first win for the season? We congratulate Gabby King, who is set to play her 100th senior women's game this weekend against Wanderers on Sunday. Earlier today, Jason Rowe was announced as the NT Thunder Academy coach. Rowe played 50 games for the Brisbane Lions and was inducted into the NT Thunder Team of the Decade earlier this year after being part of their premiership team in 2011. He has had a successful assistant coaching career at both NT Thunder and the Nightcliff Tigers, and he is currently the Tigers under-18 boys coach. We're sure he is going to do a great job with our aspiring territory footballers. AFLNT congratulates Patron-in-Chief of the Michael Long Learning and Leadership Centre and AFLNT Team of the Century inductee Michael Long on being named 2019 NT Australian of the Year. A premiership player at both St Mary's in the NTFL and Essendon in the AFL, Long has been a champion advocate for reconciliation and continues his good work through the Michael Long Foundation and by supporting the Michael Long Learning and Leadership Centre based in Murara, as well as the Long Walk. After coaching NT Thunder to a premiership in 2015, former St Kilda and Brisbane Lions player Xavier Clarke took off to Melbourne to join the Richmond Football Club coaching panel, where he enjoyed premiership success in 2017. But let's not forget he started his career as a junior with NTFL club St Mary's, and he dropped in for a chat with us while he's been home in Darwin. He even gave his favourite NTFL commentator a special plug.
Well, Xavier Clarke, welcome back to Darwin. What have you been up to on your off-season break?
Been pretty cruisy at the moment. We've sort of obviously got a 9-week-old bub, little Xena, so things have been a little bit different this year, and we've been sort of relaxing back in Melbourne for a couple of weeks, and been back up here for a week and a bit now, catching up with all the family, and did a bit of fishing, which is nice, and getting my Darwin tan back, which has been great as well.
So tell me, who caught the biggest fish on the fishing trip?
Dan Harris actually did. We got a 105 centimetre barra, which was really nice, and I was lucky enough to land an 88 centimetre on the last day, which was fantastic, but it was just good to get out on the boat and have the line on the water and reset the batteries.
So you've been away from Darwin for a couple of years now. What do you miss most about territory footy?
I think just the pureness of it, the raw talent that we see run around in the territory, and obviously the young players that get an opportunity to play senior footy as well. And like I said, probably the pureness is probably the one that you see the most. And I think the goal from was it Simon Mankara in the first round, where he ran from the halfback flank and ran around all the way to the forward line, kicked the goal. Like, you don't see that very often, and you get that in the territory, which I love most about NT footy for sure.
And you've obviously got family ties at St Mary's with your brothers playing. Have you been able to watch a bit of footy while you're here?
Yeah, but lucky enough with the live stream, with AFLNT live stream's been really good. Being able just to sit at home and watch the footy, and my favourite commentator Nick O'Reilly, I'm doing a great job. So it's fun to watch. Obviously, like I said, the pureness of it, and footy in summertime in Melbourne's always great to be able to turn on the TV and and log in, which has been great. And like I said, we sit back and watch, you know, Saints games, but also the other games that are on as well, which has been good.
Nick will be very happy with that plug. Well, let's whip into your tips for the weekend. We've got the Tiwi Bombers and St Mary's over on the islands at 2 p.m. on Saturday.
Yeah, look, it's you know, it's always a good game, always a great game, Saints and Tiwi. Obviously got really good family connections as well between the two teams, and my heart sticks with St Mary's, but I think Tiwi are going to probably be hard to beat over there.
And then we've got a massive triple header here at TIO Stadium on Saturday afternoon, and we kick it off with Wanderers and Palmerston.
Yeah, look, it's hard to tell. You know, great mate Scrubbers coaching the Muck Marks, and you know, and Alwyn Dave, Froggy's coaching the Palmerston Magpies. So it's, look, it's hard to toss the coin between them. I might have to go Palmerston by 5 points.
Darwin Buffaloes and Waratah?
I'm going to have to go Darwin Buffs on that one.
And then we've got a top of the table clash. Southern Districts are playing Nightcliff to finish off the afternoon.
Yeah, it'd be great, Graham. I think Southern Districts have been in great form, so have Nightcliff, but I'm going to have to stick with the Districts on that one.
Thanks, X-Man, and it's been great to have you back here in Darwin, and all the best back in Melbourne with the Richmond Tigers next season.
Thanks, Cruz. We appreciate it.
We wish Xavier all the best for 2019 with the Mighty Tigers. Before we go, let's look at Round 6 play of the round winner. When voting closed this morning, it was St Mary's young gun Stephen Lambton that earned him a $100 Intersport voucher for having the best highlight of the week with this exciting goal. Congratulations to Anthony Lufat, whose vote for Stephen earned him the fan prize. Enjoy the footy action wherever you are, and remember to get your tips in for this huge weekend. We'll see you next time on the Friday Footy Show.